NBC reporter runs her mouth about Trump, Sarah puts her in her place with one damning word. The liberal media just doesn't care about honor, dignity, or respect anymore. In fact, an ABC News reporter demonstrated just that by running her mouth about President Donald Trump in the White House press briefing room. Too bad for her, things would immediately backfire as White House Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders put the woman in her place, and it took just one damning word to do it. With the left running out of pathetic and desperate tactics to use in their pursuit to take President Trump down, it seems that they don't care about exposing their bias anymore. With pompous morons like CNN's Jim Acosta continually embarrassing himself, it looks like others are willing to humiliate themselves by pushing the bounds as far as they can as well. As Mad World News previously reported, Acosta was recently humiliated after President Donald Trump personally told him to get out of the Oval Office. Of course, Acosta fails to understand that when you treat someone like garbage, they're likely going to respond in kind, and he even took to Twitter to whine about how he was violated, despite it being entirely his fault. Sadly, it looks like Acosta's behavior is rubbing off on others in the press pool as yet another reporter decided to run her mouth in the White House press briefing room most recently. In fact, Cecilia Vega, senior White House correspondent for ABC News, threw thinly veiled attacks at President Donald Trump, essentially calling him a racist, while insinuating that his shithole comments had discriminatory undertones. Does a good deal include then preferring white immigrants from Norway rather than black and brown immigrants from Haiti? The reporter asked. Too bad for her, White House Press Secretary Sarah Sanders was about to put her in her place, and it would just take one damning word to do it, colorblind. In response to Cecilia Vega's loaded question, Sarah Sanders shot back, "In fact, it's actually the opposite because by definition a merit-based system is colorblind. It's not basing it on any of that criteria. It's not based on race, not based on religion, not based on country of origin. It's actually was based on the merits of whether or not this person is going to be contributing to society." Sanders continued, "Actually, it erases all those things and makes it a much more fair system instead of picking and choosing, trying to meet different quotas of different things," as the Daily Caller reports. As if that brutal takedown wasn't already enough, things only got better from there as Sarah continued her response. In fact, she next took aim at the dirty Democrats who aren't willing to deal on immigration, and she went full nuclear on them. "It's a merit-based system and, frankly, a system that most Democrats supported and voted for just 2 years ago. Now that this president is championing it, they are showing just absolute signs and definition of what hypocrisy looks like," Sanders pointed out. "Look, the bottom line is, we want a deal on DACA. They want a deal on DACA. We want a deal on border security. They want a deal on border security. They said they support these things. They also said in the past they support merit-based immigration," the press secretary continued, and she wasn't done there. "I don't see what is complicated here. We all want the same things. Democrats need to quit playing politics and start doing what they were elected to do, and that is governing, and they need to come to the table with the real deal based on the parameters that were discussed in the meeting that most of you saw, and let's try to get something done for the American people," Sanders concluded. Although some people say that this was a rare occurrence, where it appeared as if Sarah Huckabee Sanders was about to lose her temper, I personally don't think this was the case. In fact, Sarah looked cooler than ever, having full confidence in what she was saying. She was just passionate, and for good reason. The Democrats have all made a complete 180-degree turn from their prior direction, and it's all to spite President Donald Trump. They know that they've all supported in the past what he's proposing now, but because liberals are blinded by bias, they oppose the policy in order to oppose the president, even though it's hurting our country. The left can chant things like country before party all they want, but they're going to have to practice what they preach if they want others to follow along. At this point, they're the biggest offenders of what they complain about, and that's exactly why it's so easy for Sarah Huckabee Sanders to tear them apart, each and every time.